Welcome to another tutorial on MATLAB. In the last tutorial, we have seen the need for code generation. In this tutorial, we will see some related concept to the code generation and what the configuration of model should we have for a code generation platform. So in this case, we need to see what basically a sample time is and the concept related to the sample time. So suppose there are two runners, the runner 1 and runner 2. In this case, both are running on the same track. Here the assumption is the runner 2 is ahead of runner 1. So to catch the runner 2, the runner 1 need to run at a faster rate. That way he will be able to catch the runner 2 and win the competition. The same way we will have the concept of signal frequency as well as the sampling frequency. So here we are covering the concept of Nyquist criterion, where it is talking about the concept of sample time. At what sampling interval we will have to sample a signal so that we will get proper information from the signal. So consider runner 1 as the sampling frequency and the runner 2 as the signal frequency. So in such case, the sampling frequency should be faster than the signal frequency. So in such a case, the sampling frequency should how much be greater than the signal frequency that is described in a Nyquist criterion. So based on the Nyquist criterion, it is said that it should be at least 2 times more than the signal frequency so that you can catch the entire signal. So let's understand like how it should be sampled and what actually a sampling is. So here you can see a voltage signal, and at different interval of time that is being sampled, which is represented with the help of this red line. So at individual time instant, the values are being collected and being stored. So this is basically called a sampling, and the frequency represents the time interval within which you are sampling the signal. If the gap between these two is reducing, then your sampling frequency is more or it is increasing. If the gap between two samplings are increasing, then the frequency of sampling is decreasing. This represents the sampling frequency. Again, consider this example. Suppose you have this sine wave which is repeating over time. If you want to sample at a slower rate, then you will not be able to extract the exact information that is inside the signal. So suppose you want to connect these collected points, then it will end up creating this signal, which is not the exact signal. The exact signal is this one. So in such case, you need to increase the sampling frequency, and in the top one, which is this one, you are collecting all these points. These are the points that are being collected by increasing the sampling frequency. And once you connect all these dots, it is actually representing the entire signal, which is the actual signal that is we are trying to measure. So this is how you should be sampling, and this is the concept of sampling. At what interval a signal should be sampled. But here there is one more concept of calculation comes. If you are sampling very frequently, then you need to measure very frequently, and that also depends on how much memory and how much computation power you have. So in such a case, you can implement this Nyquist criterion and set a lower limit for the sampling frequency, and then you can sample the signal. But it is always preferable to have a higher frequency compared to a Nyquist frequency, which is 2 times the signal frequency, which is equal to the sampling frequency. So this is how you can measure any analog signal and convert it into a digital signal. This is how MATLAB also implements its sampling concept, which we can see in the models or in the solver setting in MATLAB. In case you are liking our channel, please consider subscribing. Stay updated to the channel for the latest upcoming videos. Happy learning MATLAB and have a good day.